Shalom and welcome on this special night of Hanukkah. It's the fourth night of Hanukkah, but it's also Shabbat. And we will just be praising God for his holiness, which will cover his Shabbat always. So we'll start with lighting the Hanukkah lights first, but then afterwards we will light the Shabbat candles a little later. So let's do it. Start with the shamash. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu l'adlik ner shel Chanukah. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam she'asa nisim la'avoteinu b'yamim ahem b'zman hazeh. Amen. Thank you for the miracles that you do in our lives every day. For the gift of your light and of Shabbat and of Hanukkah. I'd just like to point out here, we've got a delicious almond tart for Shabbat, baked by my friend Devora. And if you'll notice the dreidels, we have some beautiful dreidels this evening. And you can play dreidels on Shabbat, but you don't use the gelt, the Hanukkah gelt, which is money. But you can use almonds, or these are lovely sugar-coated almonds, and you'd still be able to play a happy game of dreidels. Well, our special word on this Shabbat of Hanukkah is holiness, Kedusha. And we think of the central theme of Hanukkah is the temple, Beit HaMikdash, the holy house. And that's what we're focused on in our story from our special book, The Light That Unites. And we trust for unity, we trust for togetherness at this time and amongst all Israel and amongst all God's people throughout the world. And it's called building a holy home. God commands us to build him a home, and his home is the temple in Jerusalem. That is the place he chose to place his name forever. There are three vessels of the temple, which are the ark, the table of showbread, and the menorah. And these three parallel three essential furnishings that one would generally find in a home: a bed, a table, and a lamp. Now, a 12th century rabbi called Ibn Ezra suggests that, like a bed, the ark in the Holy of Holies is a place of rest. God's quiet place of rest was the Holy of Holies. And the table of showbread is where we symbolically offer God sustenance, and the menorah provides light in the home. We would provide the same things for guests visiting our homes. But of course, God does not need us to provide for him, but especially on Shabbat, we provide this setting for God as it helps us more tangibly to feel his presence in our midst. Shabbat is like the holy place of time. So we have the lamp, we have the showbread, and we create the atmosphere where his presence of holiness will be at home on Shabbat in our homes. Now, 2,000 years ago, when the Maccabees entered the temple and lit the menorah, they celebrated a Chanukat Habayit, the rededication of the second temple in Jerusalem. The essence of the Beit HaMikdash, or temple, was to make a house of God and to create a space for the presence of God to reside. Rabbi Joseph Soloveitchik taught that this insight gives us an invaluable lesson about the purpose of our own homes. If the temple could be transformed into a house, then the private home of a child of God can be transformed into a temple. And we know even our bodies are like temples of God, and our hearts are like the Holy of Holies. But our homes especially have the opportunity to be like a mini sanctuary for the presence of God. We welcome God into our homes by sanctifying the three corresponding objects, the bed, the table, and the lamp. The bed in our homes represents family purity and shalom bayit, which is so key, that peace of the home. God's presence resides in the home when there is a deep sensitivity and love shared between a husband and wife. The table represents the mitzvot that surround the place of eating in our homes, such as eating kosher food, reciting blessings over food, and the great mitzvah of welcoming guests. Our homes are sanctified when we transform our material blessings into spiritual sustenance for our family and friends and those in need. Then we have the lamp, which offers tangible light and which also is a symbol of God's spiritual light of wisdom and enlightenment. The light represents the study of God's word. May our homes always be a center of the study of His word, the proclamation of His word, and the living out of His word. And it says in Proverbs 6:23, "For a commandment is a lamp, and the teaching of Torah is light." His word is light. And when we learn and share the teachings of the Torah with our family and all those who join us in our homes, we nourish the home with a spiritual dimension, that of His word. Right, concerning the temple, it's written in the Torah, in Exodus 25:22, "There I will meet with you and I will speak with you," God says. So in the sanctuary, we were given the opportunity to experience God's presence, and the same now can be said of our homes. When we sanctify our homes by making them a sanctuary, then the Shekhinah of God's presence indeed finds a place to dwell. So just as the miracle of the flame proclaims the presence of God in the temple, the flames that burn in our windows each night proclaim that this house is a place of God's dwelling, a place imbued with a sense of God's presence. Chanukah inspires us, as does Shabbat, to transform the stones and bricks of our homes into a family temple, a home imbued with holiness. Amen. May our homes be filled with holiness for His glory. Amen.